Hello everyone, welcome back to another unit review with me, Travis, at the Great Outdoors RV in West Greeley, Colorado. I'm about to get blown away by the wind here. We've got a storm cell moving in, but don't let that stop you from coming and see us. We're Coloradans. Listen guys, this is the new Cedar Creek that I'm standing in front of. This is their new mid-bunk model, the 377BH. Guys, this has got a beautiful bunk room, a king bed for mom and dad, really nice fit and finish as Cedar Creek always does, but also the new graphics, this modernized look from Cedar Creek is something we're really impressed with. Starts from the docking lights. They've done a really good job with that. It's elegant, it sets it off. The insignia in between the docking lights is gonna be the new Cedar Creek insignia. That's gonna be a little bit more blocky and modern. So they're just kind of changing their look altogether. However, the quality is not gonna be slipping here. So coming around the side here, I wanna show you just a few features. You've always got that big front storage there, and then you've got nice big awning here right in your living area, right outside the main door. You've got your outdoor speakers, obviously, but look at these graphics. There's even these gold inlays, and it really, really, really makes it stand out. The frameless windows, obviously, these are always gonna be insulated windows from Cedar Creek. That's the way us, the Great Outdoors RV, bring them in for you as the consumer. You've got your propane side by side. You've got two 30-pound bottles there. And then I'm gonna open the pass-through to show you. You've got that drop frame construction. So that gives you all that vertical space in your pass-through. I mean, I could sleep in there. You've got your 110 here. That's in a really good location. You've got a spray port. Now they're thoughtful enough to give you a spray port for those stairs. And those are gonna be zero gravity as well. And we'll get to that, but that's to clean them off because the new stairs that they do, all of them across the board, even though Cedar Creek's are a little better, they actually go up inside the coach. So it's great, it's an awesome system, but they're thoughtful enough to give you a way to clean them off before you put them inside this beautiful Cedar Creek. You've got a little bit of a cubby here. So this actually has a pullout. So this actually, guys, I'm sorry, this actually flips around and your inner vac is right here as well. But this is a nice tray that flips over. I'll show you the operation of that in another little video. But you've got an outside refrigerator here. So this is the perfect place if we wanted to put a grill out here. There's an LP disconnect underneath where your propane bottles are. So you can hook directly to those propane bottles and not use an extra fuel source and just that one fuel source for all of your needs, because you can't even do two grills. Call us and ask us about that if you have any questions. There's some accessories you would need. Okay, so slam latches, nice and sturdy. And these stairs. So I'm gonna talk about these stairs for a second. We're not gonna lift them up right now, but they're adjustable at the bottom and it's just a little paddle here. Whereas before you used to have to use a pan, and some of them are still doing that, but Cedar Creek is amongst the innovative to just use the paddle. And it's nice because you pull it out and you can drop them one at a time. So if you're on uneven ground, you can still get a good solid footing with your stairs. You can see the slide walls are all high gloss, marine grade gel coat. So they didn't go away from that. They did a lighter color and they did the more exaggerated graphics. But we really love them. Tell us what you think. It's really important. We know what you guys like and dislike about a product that we carry, and they want to know too. Cedar Creek does care about what you think. So you've got slide toppers on this one. We brought it in with slide toppers on this side and on the other side. And then of course your nice wheels here. These are new from Cedar Creek, and the road armor suspension. And that's going to be your central suspension. Okay, so let's take a look inside and then we'll take another jump outside to show you the docking station, because Cedar Creek does some special stuff there as well. Okay, so we're standing inside the 377BH. You meant what I knew. The mid-bunk from Cedar Creek. And Mike, he was talking about my beard. It was, when we were off camera, it was almost like I was looking at him through my beard here. And I'm like, well, do we have to do it today?
It's like Pirates out of Caribbean.
Anyway, so there's some things that Cedar Creek does differently. Some people will say, you know, I don't like the mid-bunk. It doesn't have the second bathroom, things like that. But first of all, you don't walk right into that mid-bunk room in the middle there. With Cedar Creek, they actually do a wall here. And then you're out over on the side of your kitchen is where you walk into the mid-bunk. So we think that that's definitely a difference from any of the other mid-bunks that we see. So kudos to Cedar Creek for doing that. The barn door, kind of finishes it all off. You got your like wrought iron look here, so nice sturdy arrangement, but the barn slide door is a nice touch. And then of course inside the room here, you've got plenty of room to move around. This will lay out into a bed, and don't forget about the big loft up top. Some storage to finish it all off, cabinets all over. You've got a dresser, a couple of dresser drawers here. So this is a perfect room for a teenager or, you know, really any kiddo or even an adult. The bed's big enough. So this is the mid-bunk room, and I wanted to talk about the difference. A lot of people are looking for the bunk in the back of the coach, and that's not necessarily better, because as we turn here, you can see, look how much living space I've got. The big, big difference is if I've got a bunk room in the back, well, I have a traditional type setup in the front of the coach, just like this one does, but this one has the loft up top of the bunk room instead of being in the back and closing off the living area, which there's another Cedar Creek video that we did called the 355 LF. Look at the difference. That one's super cool too, but I want you to take a look at the living area here. Take a screenshot of it and do a comparison, because big, big island, whereas the other island is smaller. This big island allows you a lot of prep area. You can put some bar stools over here. You've still got the Corian, same kind of fit and finish across from one to the next, but the living area here is a traditional fifth wheel living style, and it is huge. Big, big couch here that folds out into a bed. Theater seats right across from your entertainment. These are gonna all be from Allure, so this is nice, comfortable stuff that'll last you. High quality furniture, and then if you look around at the accents, the lighter colors, Cedar Creek knocked it out of the park. You've got an electric fireplace here where you're heating the room without your propane, so you don't need fuel, you're all plugged in. Take the chill off of the room to make breakfast, what have you. Speaking of which, Insignia, 35,000 BTU, full-size oven. So they knocked it out of the park with that too. And actually, when these were introduced to us, they cooked a turkey in it. So they're very capable, unlike a lot of them on the market. The black finishes are kind of new, and then the black inlays in the cabinetry. And then you'll see in the bathroom, they went to a full white cabinetry, which is great. It really opens it up. Okay, got the beard all combed. We are inside from out of the wind there. We just talked about the living area. This one is actually on the loft for the mid-bunk. This is another thing they do differently. You see these stairs? That's safe. You've got some traction here, some non-slip. The stairs are big enough to get a little foot on there, even an adult foot if you want to get up here and go to sleep. The vertical space that they allow makes this a pretty usable space for sleeping. You can even put a little TV up here if you want. And then, of course, there's a max air fan right up above the bed. So that'll exhaust the coach all the way through, because you've got the wrought iron look here as well, which is an open area, so it'll pull from this too. Coming down the hallway, I'm going to have Mike back up. You can see your bathroom here. You've got a walk-in shower with the built-in sit-down. Now, a lot of them will have the walk-in shower that are this size, but not always the built-in sit-down. The black finishes continue here. The white cabinetry, like I told you about, really, really a nice look. The linen storage off to the side of the shower, and another max air fan right above you. Walking into the bedroom, here's that king bed I was telling mom and dad about. The masters of the coach are gonna have this room, and it's absolutely beautiful. As you're looking around, you can see that there's shelves designed for a CPAP machine or anything you really wanna put up there, but they're elevated above the windows so that they're out of the way. It used to be that those shelves would be right where your elbows are, or you know, you smack into them. Cedar Creek listened and they made some changes. You've also got a TV here from Insignia. This is gonna have, it's gonna have a window here. You do have windows on both sides of the slide underneath those CPAP shelves and the kind of sconce that they created. Your dresser here is very usable. You've got four identical drawers, and these are nice and deep and high quality wood. You've got your thermostat here. Everything's gonna be a ducted AC. As always with Cedar Creek, they didn't change any of that. You've got a residential return just like you would in your house. The cap closet, you can still put a washer and dryer in here. It's the same kind of arrangement as before. They did just change the coloration and this accent piece here as well. So can lights up there, and those are gonna be your accent lights. And then you got a king Wi-Fi system on the wall and the backside of the closet itself. A nice light here to light everything up, and just a really usable big closet. And then of course the king bed is super comfortable, but also I can get all the way around the bed, no problem. I can make the bed. A lot of them you can't, and that's one of the bigger concerns. And it's always this space right here
that's so small you can't do that. So this one is different than that, and I can actually turn sideways and moonwalk out. No, I'm kidding. So you can get around the same side over here, which is always, that's not always the concern, but some of them, that you can't do it on both of them. But with Cedar Creek, you can definitely get around the bed. USBs, 110s on both sides, and of course, just a beautiful bedroom with a lot of usable space. All right, so back in the living area, a few things I didn't point out. Panoramic windows all the way around. No, we've got them closed for the video quality, but you've got two-way shades here. So you've got the shades where you can see out just fine and people can't see in. Those are your daytimes. And then they have the pull-downs, and they're both on rollers, which is great. No strings, guys. I mean, obviously with Cedar Creek, you wouldn't see that, but the two-way shades aren't always gonna be an option. So the slide toppers, the two-way shades, there's a lot that's different about this coach. The barn door, this big refrigerator right behind me, I'm gonna open it so you can see the size of this thing. It's got the multi-airflow. This is run by an inverter that's already on the coach. I mean, you're set and ready to go. Get the right battery set up by talking to us and we'll get you in the right direction. This is it. I mean, this is amazing. The Cedar Creek Mid-Bunk is really gonna be a hit. I think the changes that they made are classy. I think that they left what worked in place, and I think you guys will really like it. Come and see it. Rest Greeley. Again, we're the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Travis. You can call me directly at the number you see on the screen, or you can come visit us in West Greeley. And remember, we're as Colorado as it gets. Oh, by the way, I didn't want to forget, and Mike wouldn't let me anyway, but we have a brand new podcast, and this is going to operate on all of your platforms for podcasts. So whichever one you use, you can access it by searching the Great Outdoors RV. Thank you so much. We'll see you here again soon.